So let us go back to our discussion on the converter that we were considering. See, why we came to this is we saw that there is a DC side voltage Vd. We just got the expression for the average value of Vd, but there are harmonic components in Vd. So Vd is given by 6 different expressions. See, we saw that one cycle can be divided into 6 intervals of duration 60 degrees, and in each 60 degree duration, say first duration we considered alpha to alpha plus 60 degrees, then alpha plus 60 degree to alpha plus 120, and so on. So in each of these intervals, Vd has an expression. So what are these expressions? I mean, if you look at the expressions, what are these voltages? What is the value expression for Vd from alpha to alpha plus 60? We formed a table, right? So from alpha to alpha plus 60 degree, Vd is Eb minus Ec. What is Eb minus Ec? It is nothing but the line voltage. And alpha plus 60 to alpha plus 120, what it is? It is a different expression. It is Eb minus Ea. It is another line voltage. So if you look at the 6 expressions in the 6 intervals, all these are line voltages. Now these are all line voltages, are all equal, all are equal in magnitude and displaced by 60 degrees. Actually, you can verify that, say there is Eb minus Ec, there is also an expression for Vd in another interval, which is Ec minus Eb. Okay. So there are 6 waveforms which are equal in magnitude, which are line voltages and displaced by 60 degrees. Say, I hope there is no confusion, there are only 3 line voltages, why I am talking about 6? We have the 3 line voltages plus the negative of these 3. So if I want to get the waveform of Vd, what I should do? What is the best way of getting waveforms? See, if I want to draw. So in this course, what will be useful is use some package to draw the 6 waveforms and then try to trace manually using a pencil the waveform of Vd. Now we get different waveforms based on different values of, see, just by looking at the 6 waveforms we can't get Vd. One more quantity has to be specified to draw alpha. So what I would suggest is, first, I would not suggest a freehand plotting of the 6 line voltages. That you can do using any package. Just take it as a dotted line, 6 line voltages. Then over that you try to plot the waveform of Vd. So try to plot this. So let me give an exercise. Plot Vd for different values of alpha. So alpha is equal to, so let me start with 0 itself. 0 is the simplest thing. 0, 30 degrees, 60 degrees, and so on. Up to what value can we go? Is there any limit? 90. Beyond that? Yeah, let it, it can operate as an inverter also. It can operate as an inverter also. Okay, let me list the values. 90 you can go, fine. You can go to 90 also, then 120, then 1. You can go up to 150. What about 180? Huh? Can we go beyond this? Of course, we can't go beyond this if I just take in steps of 30. Of course, I can go to 151. I can go to 152. Okay. Now, can I go to 180 is the question. So you try and see what happens if you go to up to 180. Okay. I will not try to give the answer. So I have given a hint. See, what is the exercise? Exercise is easy. You just take a printout of the 6 waveforms, maybe a dotted or a dashed line as a sinusoidal curve, 6 waveforms which are sinusoidal displaced by 60 degrees. Over that, plot Vd. Okay, try to sketch Vd for different values of alpha, of course, for different values of alpha. So I have given 6 values of alpha. Okay. So we will come to why this should stop at somewhere just below 180. why we can't go up to 180, or we will see that we can't go even near 180, say for example 175 and so on. So, we will see that, we will come to that. Okay. So, we will see why it can't go. But is it clear why we can't go up to 180 or greater than 180? Look at the definition of alpha. See, what is alpha? Alpha, I mean the name given to alpha is delay angle. Now, it is nothing but the delay by which val 3 is turned on with respect to instant of natural computation, instant of natural conduction. So, that is the definition. So, using that definition, we can try to make out why there is a restriction on alpha, why we can't have alpha equal to or greater than 180. Okay. So, you try to plot this, you will get the answer. Okay. So, we have already got the average value of Vd. Of course, for that we do not need a Fourier series, but there are harmonic components in Vd. Now, the question is, what is the order of the harmonic components in Vd? Harmonic components in Vd. See, Vd is the DC side voltage, or of order H equal to what? Yeah, one point to note is that in this course, all waveforms have the same period, that is 2 pi. All waveforms have the same period 2 pi. See, even the DC side voltage, see, you can have a lesser value, less value of the period. You can even have, instead of 2 pi radians, you can have, say, instead of 360 degrees, you can have 60 degrees also. But we will stick to a period of 360 degree for both the AC side as well as DC side. Okay. So, when I say harmonic component, say the harmonic component will have a higher frequency and a lower period. Okay. So, when I talk of harmonic component of Vd, what I am talking about is the DC side voltage. So, the desirable component of Vd is the average value. The undesirable, unwanted things are the harmonic components. So, going by the definition of our period is 2 pi radians, what is the value of H, which is the order of harmonic components in Vd? What is the first harmonic component that you get in Vd? See, in the last class, we got an expression for average value. So, I will not try to repeat that. We got an average value of Vd. Okay. We also saw that for some values of alpha, the average value is positive. For some values of alpha, it can be negative. Okay. Now, whether it is positive or negative becomes more clear if you try to plot. So, for alpha equal to 30 or 0, the waveform will be always above the omega, I mean always above the abscissa. Okay. So, you can easily make out that for some values of alpha, it is positive, or some values of alpha, it is negative. Now, the question is, if I come to the harmonic components, what are the harmonic components that are there in Vd? Suppose I have the omega ot equal to omega ot axis here. Suppose I take alpha equal to 0, simplest case. So, if alpha is equal to 0, then I will have, these are all line voltages, these are all pieces of line voltages. So, if I take one cycle, so one cycle is 360 degrees and it can be divided into 6 intervals, each of duration 60 degrees. So, this is the waveform that we get for alpha equal to 0. For alpha greater than 0, what will be the waveform? It will deviate from this. So, I want you to draw that. Though you may have some idea, you would have already learnt it as well, but you still draw that. That is the exercise that I have given you. Okay. So, each of these durations is 60 degrees. Okay. I given sufficient hint. Now, can you tell me what is the order of the harmonic components in Vd, at least for this alpha equal to 0? Sorry? Even multiples of 3. So, the first even multiple is 6. then 12, yeah, right. Yeah, it's right. I mean, I don't know why you are saying even multiple of 3. Why not you say multiples of 6? Multiples of 6, right? So I can say that for h equal to 6k, where k takes all positive integer values. So though I have drawn the waveform for alpha equal to 0, even for a higher value, a non-zero or positive value of alpha, we can see that the harmonic components are of order 6, 12 and 18, so on. Okay. So, for any value of h which is equal to 6k, where k is any positive integer, what is the RMS value? We are interested in the RMS value. Now, why we are interested in the RMS value? We want to see how much deviation is there from the ideal waveform. So, the ideal waveform or the desired waveform is a constant value of Vd. We cannot get constant, but we want as close to constant as possible. So, the deviation from the desired waveform is given by the harmonic components. So, we usually measure it by RMS value. So, if I take the RMS value of the hth order harmonic component. So, please note, when I say hth order, I am talking about the hth order for which the harmonic component is non-zero. Obviously, I have already said that the harmonic components of order, say if I take h equal to 1, then it is 0. What is h equal to 1 in this case? See, fundamental makes sense only on the AC side. What makes sense on the DC side is average. Okay. So, h equal to 1 is not corresponding to fundamental on the DC. We talk about fundamental on the AC side. Fundamental component, we mentioned fundamental component only on the AC side. When you talk about DC side, it is average value. Okay. So, if you take h equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then the harmonic component corresponding to these values of h is 0. Again, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, any value other than 6k, the harmonic component is 0. So, RMS value of hth order harmonic component of Vd. So, I will use the notation Vh. So, please note what I am trying to say is h equal to 6k, where k is 1, 2, 3, so on. So, for these values of h, the harmonic component has an RMS value Vh. So, for RMS value of harmonic component of order h, I use uppercase V with a subscript h. So, the lowercase v was used for instantaneous, uppercase V with a subscript h. So, we know how to use Fourier series. I will give the answer, I will leave it to you to derive this. Okay. So, the expression is root 2 V d o. What is V d o? You will be using these notations again and again. Maximum average DC voltage divided by h square minus 1 into square root of 1 plus h square minus 1 sin square alpha.